So here's Harrington.
Hey everybody, Rich with Mustang Connection. Thanks for stopping by. Going to be covering a few things today. We're doing mail calls, lots of mail calls, and featuring a Shelby GT 500 convertible. So check it out. Here comes the mail calls. Check out the GT 500. Thanks everybody for watching. I hope you enjoy. I'm going to repeat myself a little bit because I introduced myself a couple times because I kept meaning to put these mail calls in. So I apologize. Have a wonderful Easter for all those who celebrate it. Thumbs up. See y'all soon.
So here's Heritage. It's a 69 GT 500 in royal maroon and white, next to a Laguna Seca Boss Rio 2. So a 2012 Laguna Seca Boss 302. And it's parked right next to a 69 GT 500 Shelby convertible. Guess what? This looks like an original paint car. Sure appears to be. With original polyglass tires on it.
Hey everybody, it's Rich with Mustang Connection and Muscle Car Connection. So thanks so much for stopping by. I thought I would kind of share with you what's going on. I've got a mail call that I'm a little late on. So this will be a quintuple mail call. So that's five for you counting at home. Am I saying that right? Quadruple, quintuple. Yes, it's a quintuple. I had to check myself. So there'll be five today, five shout outs. So for those of you that watch, I know a lot of the guys in the YouTube Garage Gang, we all kind of share our experiences from restorations to hobbies to everything in between, and so I'm going to share some great channels here. Little update right here, this 69 El Camino that's in here right now is getting completely rewired. My buddy that's doing the work on that, on the his 65 Mustang, is basically dormant right now while he takes paid work in and rewires the dash. It's going from a standard dash, I think, to a tack dash, and so he's handling the wiring. The car had some shorts before that, and so I think he's handling that, and then he's kind of refreshing the whole deal. In conjunction with trying to get a Scion running for his son, so he's been pretty busy, and as a result, we've kind of had this area tied up. I've been busy with a lot of those projects, as you've seen. I've got a couple more coming up. I've shot a lot of video. I just haven't had time to post it yet, so stay tuned. Okay, on to the mail call. Redneck Railroad, Stan and Ryan. If you have not checked him out, you should. They have all kinds of great stuff going on. He just finished a pretty in-depth quadrajet carburetor rebuild. They just bought a new Camaro for his wife. And he's a motorcycle guy, obviously railroad stuff, and just a good guy. Just good guys to check out. And you know, I did enjoy kind of what one of his discussions before they bought the brand new Camaro was just talking about sometimes you got to let stuff go to bring new things into your life. And it's true. I mean, how many projects are you really going to get to in your lifetime? I think the key is to just focus on what you can focus on. At the end of the day, they really are material things. I mean, everyone agrees that loved ones are far more important than any of these material things that you could possibly put in your life. And you really are a custodian. I mean, these cars live on. I mean, somebody bought these cars new in the 40s, 50s, 60s that are no longer here, and someone has taken the time to work on them, restore them, and they live on. So anyhow, I thought that was kind of a cool message about making room. You know, he basically had to get rid of something to get something else. And so anyhow, he wrote me a nice note too. Really enjoying the new channel. Always watching Mustang Connection 2. Thanks for subbing and watching our stuff. You gotta love the YouTube thing. I agree. It's a lot about camaraderie. So thank you for that. I'm gonna put his sticker up.
So Chris, I shot your video for Dad Shake 73 and I cannot find it. I lost it somehow amongst the sea of other videos. So I meant to do it with the same time I did Lloyd's Rusty Glove Box. But anyhow, make sure you check out Chris's channel. He does all kinds of projects. He loves Harbor Freight. He does stuff with the family. Actually, he's just doing a rear end right now on a Chevelle. Looked like a 9-inch, though. It looked like they were retrofitting with a 9-inch when the pumpkin was going in. So anyway, make sure you check out Chris's channel. Shakes 73. Chris does all kinds of cool stuff.
Cutworm. Everybody knows Steve, or a lot of people know Steve. If you've not checked out Cutworm 59, you have to. He likes to shoot dead trees, for one thing. Anyway, that was one of his recent things. He was pulling this tree down. But no, check out his Crosley named Harold. It's very cool. Steve's just a great YouTuber, man. Just very sincere, very down to earth. Everyone is, but I mean, Steve, you know, goes out of his way to comment on all the videos, and in addition to putting up tons himself, just a really nice guy. Check it out. In fact, if you want to see some of what's going on another channel that is Stevie's related, it's related to Steve's, Matt at Buck's Woodshop is redoing a dash for Harold right now. So anyway, love you, Stevie. Great stuff. And there's another sticker in here. I don't know what I did with it. So Steve, I can't find that other sticker, but it's about tools. Not leaving them out or don't look in the toolbox. Anyway, I'll find it. I'll stick it up on another video, but I loved it, dude. Cutworm 59, Stevie, I found it. Like a week later, you're going to see it. I'm going to attach it to this other video, so check it out. It says, no tools are left in this toolbox overnight. They can be found all over the garage floor. Who hasn't had that experience? I love this, Steve. Thanks so much. And his notes on here, too. Hi, Rich. Thank you very much for joining our Nut House. Your channel brings much needed quality. Best regards, Steve. So thanks, Stevie. Again, Cutworm 59. This will go on the toolbox. Thanks for watching. Awesome. So again, check out Cutworm 59. Steve is a good dude, man. Okay. And then I also got one from Larry Z24. You wrote me a little note too. Thanks for the sticker. I'll put it in a place of honor. Hey, Larry, I appreciate it. If you haven't checked out Larry's channel, he is very active right now, and he is very good about commenting and being engaged and stuff. And if you didn't know, he's definitely a Chevy guy. But what's cool is, as I mentioned, I think everybody on here is really good about sharing their experience, and it's less about the brand and more about the process for the most part. So anyway, if you haven't checked out Larry's channel, please do, Larry Z24, and you can see what he's working on right now. Okay, so kind of circling back, I have a mail call from Scottson, Florida, and it's not a sticker, it's a cool pool ball, number 14, and he's engraved Scottson, Florida on it. If you've not checked out Scott's channel, he wrote me a little note too, please do. His note says, hi Rich, thanks for all the great bids, keep them coming. Warning to not hang from the rearview mirror, laugh out loud. So, Scott is in Florida, and Scott starts all of his videos. He has a little clip of his really cool Corvette starting up, and you can just hear the sound. The thing's a ground pounder. And he's got a bunch of projects, very seasoned guy, very knowledgeable person, and also he's going to be starting on a new Edge Mustang. He's doing a swap on a 5.4 in for the 4.6. So please check out Scott's in Florida. Thank you, Scott, for this. Very nice. Very active YouTube Garage Gang member. Thanks, everybody, for watching that. And see you all soon. Have a wonderful weekend.
Alrighty, there they are. Check out the latest. Larry Z24. That's Larry. Yeah, Chris at Dad Shake 73. Lloyd, Rusty Glove Box, Ryan and Stan, Redneck Railroad, or Steve, Cutworm 59. So make sure and check them out. Please check out everybody else. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see y'all soon.